Morning! Hello, welcome to King's Cross St Pancras in London. Welcome to a brand new Disneyland Paris vlog series. Me and my friend Gary are heading off for 2 nights and staying at Newport Bay in Disneyland Paris. Last time we did this was May last year. It's currently February, so it's a bit chilly. We didn't really like Sequoia Lodge when we stayed there last time, mainly because it just needed a bit of refurb and the amount you're paying. We wanted to go for somewhere that was about the same price but hopefully better, and Newport Bay apparently got refurbished not too long ago. So we're looking forward to that. We're travelling via Eurostar, hence why we're at King's Cross. And we've also got standard Premier tickets because they were like £11 difference, and it's a bit more spacious and you apparently get food. We did standard class last time in May, but we did do standard Premier like 2015, which was Gary's first trip to a Disney park ever. There is a vlog series on this channel somewhere. I'll link it below if you want to go and check that out. But Gary's on his way. It's Wednesday the 12th of February and we both have to travel in rush hour to get here, so I hope you enjoy the series. Now, as it's only a couple nights, I've only got the little case, but if you've seen my channel before, you'll know that Gary has a somewhat of a case saga, so we'll see what he's brought. As per usual, Gary is lost. It's not like we did this last year and I told him, meet me outside the Eurostar. Oh, Gary.
Hello. I was just in John Lewis.
John Lewis?
Yes, because somebody brought the wrong headphones for their phone, because I have an iPhone and they don't do the little thing. Anyway, hello.
I was just admiring, Gary brought a practical bag. Look at you bringing a size that's appropriate for the trip.
I stuck my niece's stickers on it so I knew it was mine.
Gary C, the luggage strikes back.
Sandcastles and a palm tree, just in case the weather changes to what it says on the app.
Are you excited about Disneyland Paris?
I am very excited, to the point where I've had 5 hours sleep.
Are you excited about the fact we're traveling in standard Premier?
What's that mean?
It's not standard what we did last time. It's a nicer seat and you get a croissant.
Oh, you get a croissant? Did you say that to them? You'll be very pleased with the croissant.
I told them that I upgraded us. It's like £11.
You know, oh,
compared
wow.
to when we were doing it in May, they quoted like £60 each way per person.
Because it's the quiet week before half term.
Yeah.
We love that.
We love that.
Let's see what else we can get for being with not the kids.
We could get, because we're going to be on the train over lunch, we could get something more substantial than just a croissant. Just
we
like
could,
a sandwich.
But don't buy it on the train. Because I spent €20 on just a sandwich and something once.
No. There is an M&S Simply Food right next to the Eurostar thing, so we'll just go there and get some noms.
Podcast ready. I'm going to get some Percy Pigs, but I'm not going to choke on them. If you've seen the last series, you know what I'm talking
about.
Don't
make promises you can't keep.
We picked up a meal deal each. You can take food through, and you also can take coffee through. But we learned last time.
Awkward.
Don't bother with that. Because you have to put it in a tray, and you've got like all your hands like cluttered and stuff.
And if they separate you from the pack to then do the touchdown thing, then you've got the awkward coffee.
Oh, nightmare. So, our advice, don't bother with the coffee. But we are going to head through now. Got to go to security things, so we'll see you when we're in the waiting room. I can speak English. Security was a breeze.
Really easy.
You said that like coming through half term it might be troublesome.
Yes, so if you're coming in half term I would get there early so that you just get in and get a seat, because if you do a quick pan across you'll see that there's no chairs in here in the lounge. And there's loads of people standing up, so if you've got kids obviously that's going to be a bit ugh.
Yeah, so they opened the security line about 2 hours before the train departs. So we're 10:14 to Disneyland, so I think it's been delayed by 4 minutes.
Good morning, ladies.
4 minutes? What will I do?
We're gonna miss everything. Oh, seats! Let's go,
chairs,
go, go,
chairs,
go, go,
chairs.
Go.
Mother needs a perch. We've got a perch. We've got a patch.
So the idea is that if you time it when a train is literally just boarding, you can get a seat. I've changed the setting. It's been like whitewashed the whole time.
Sorry about that.
I'm trying to change the settings so that the focus works better, but not having much luck. What are you doing, Canon? So they have a coffee shop here, and they also have a Pret down there and a World Duty Free. We're sat here. Gary's on his phone.
I'm on my phone looking at my pins. This is my pin collection, a very quick overview. Are you ready? Because you're always asking me. Go for it. So they're the Disney Cruise ones. They're Disneyland Paris and miscellaneous non-official ones. They're Disney Worlds and miscellaneous Christmassy Disney store. They're the sets. Don't judge. They're my last Disneyland Paris trip. And this is my last... Oh God, I got a lot in Disney World, didn't I? So, you need to calm down. Step on these gowns. Future Adam knows why that's funny, because I'm singing it, and that's the only bit of the song that I know, and it's driving him insane.
La, la, la. So we've got about an hour until our train leaves, and I appreciate that we probably get across on the train, but we're both ravenous. I got up at 4:45 a.m.
Did you? I got up at 5:45.
So I had like a little breakfast bar on the way, but it's not substantial enough. So we got a cheese and tomato croissant for me, a croissant for Gary from the station pantry just over there. I did debate going to Pret, but Pret was incredibly busy. And if you know me, I'm very impatient and don't like to stand in lines for too long. So
also, whilst Adam was going over there to get the little treats, I went on the Line Bertie app, which is the app that you use.
If you want to meet characters at Disneyland Paris, it's not like Disney World where you
So it looks like that. Up. Can you see that?
I probably can get the outline of it. Hang on.
It's like... So basically you use that to book characters in the Walt Disney Studios. Now it does...
And that's not a fast pass. That's just so you have permission to line up.
Yeah, so basically you get a ticket and it's like a partnership between Disneyland Paris and this app. So the Line Bertie app, you need to download that. Then what you need to do is you need to be up in France when you get up at 8:45 at least before it goes live and be ready, because in an hour they have literally got rid of, for the whole day and evening, Buzz Lightyear and Friends, the random Disney characters, Olaf and Friends, Woody and Friends, and the other Olaf and Friends PM. They've done everything in the space of like a very short time. So you need to be up, you need to be on that Line Bertie app, and you need to be getting on it.
They have a couple of characters that you don't have to do that for.
Well, in the main park, you don't use the app. In Disneyland Park, you don't use
it's
the app.
It's only the studios?
Only the studios. The other one uses the usual system of just turn up.
It just seems complicated for the sake of being complicated, but...
It is what it is.
So we gave up our seats because
we love standing up.
We saw the people, like the people who work on the train, going up to prepare the train, and we're like, oh, the train's departing in 15 minutes, we'll be going in time soon. Literally the second we stood up and got in line to like go through the thing, delayed. Granted, it's only delayed by like 15 minutes, and we can overhear a conversation with the lady who works here saying like the train driver will hopefully try and catch it up in the train, like so yeah. Don't stand up until they call you. We learned our lesson.
Yay!
Hooray!
And then please come forward. Use any of the two doors. Thank you.
I got distracted and I went down the wrong one.
We come to Disneyland because I watched you.
Oh, thank you! As we were coming up the escalator, there was a very nice family in front of us. The lady turned around and went, the whole reason I'm coming on the Disney trip is because I watch your vlogs. So thanks for watching. Where's I don't catch your name, but thank you. So what did you say? Where's my commission? I mean, Disney, hit me up. I'm excited. I love the Eurostar.
Oh, you feel that breeze? It's tickling my tonsils.
Carriage number 15.
This station is patrolled by uniformed and plainclothes police.
Madam?
For your safety and security.
Ooh!
Picture.
Is this the right one?
I don't know, but there's no one in there, so picture.
Maybe it's not the right one. So let's try that again. Adam read it wrong. I thought it was coach 15, seat 11. It's the other way around. It's
still in the picture.
Coach 11, seat 15. Take two.
Here we go.
We've got this little couple duo here.
Oh yeah. Ooh. That's nice.
Forward or backwards?
I don't care.
I'll go forwards then. So this is a standard premier seat. Ooh la la. Plenty of leg room. Gary not included. Little pop-out tray.
Here's behind the keyhole. Or whatever it is, I don't know.
There's a little button for a light here.
Ooh, I like that.
Very fancy. There's also a plug, which works for European and UK by the looks of it. Nope, that's a lie, that's European. And also a USB port as well.
That's good.
Handy. Little numbers to tell you where you are. Rack for like little things, and then a rack for your slightly bigger suitcases. And we're right by the luggage storage as well.
Let's get the Instagram, start the
hashtag, right. So we just had a lovely cast member in a red t-shirt come by, who's also based in Coach 8, if you need to see them. And basically, we've paid for the Disney Luggage Service. It's £30 for both of us.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't actually book it with the Eurostar. So the way I booked it was Newport Bay and park tickets and luggage service with Disney, and then the Eurostar I booked directly through Eurostar, mainly because it was cheaper, and also Disneyland Paris wasn't showing any availability. So it's funny how they've like linked the two without having to book two together, which is a bonus. Basically, he's given us these blue tags to put on our luggage. He also said it's very important that we leave these on for our return, so don't take it off.
Because I know what you like.
Everyone in the comments is like, we know what he's like.
They've also gave us an envelope, which includes some recapped information about what he just told us, our magic passes, which are our park tickets, so we can go straight in, and then also the receipts to pick up our bags from the hotel later tonight. So the way the luggage service works is you pay £30, you drop your bags off when you get into Marne-la-Vallée station, you can then go straight into the parks. Then when you check into your hotel later, your bags have been transferred to the hotel for you, and likewise they do it on the reverse when you're leaving. So hope we're going to test it out. We didn't do this last time, but we'll see if it's saves us putting our bags in drop luggage.
Yeah, saves us having to carry them.
Thank you.
Inside your bag, you've got your cup for your tea and coffee. If you take that out from now, so you can do your coffee now.
Yeah, okay. Sure.
And then you've got water, you've got orange juice, yogurt.
Oh, oh wow.
Thank you.
You're
welcome, enjoy. When you're all done, put everything back in the bag, we're
connected
for you.
Okay. Perfect.
Loads of stuff.
I mean, lots of single-use plastic. Adam's not happy.
Save the turtles.
However, there is a jam that you can smear on your croissant in the wrong way.
In the wrong way, yeah.
So you do get a bread roll. You also get a...
I'm just eating it dry. I'm so hungry, I'm just eating it now.
Croissant, yogurt, a little cup for your tea, mineral water, jam, orange juice, and butter. As well as wooden cutlery. Why give wooden cutlery and then plastic cups? I don't know. Why? It's not necessary.
Save the turtles and the alligators.
It's definitely not worth the upgrade for the food.
I like it.
You like it? I don't know. I don't know. This is, if you were paying £60 extra for this.
Pop off the water.
I don't know.
We're in France now. Ooh la la. I've forgotten.
Bonjour. Sortie.
Sortie. Space Mountain.
Here.
Someone was in the toilet for ages. I thought they were dead.
We have arrived! Sorry we didn't vlog much on the train. We got talking to this lovely family sat next to us.
Yes.
Leanne, Kay and George, if you're watching. Hi! So the time just went like that.
Yeah, we're here.
Talk about Disney Worlds.
Yeah,
we're here.
About Disney Cruise, the Lani, everything.
So we're just heading up to the upper level to go and drop our cases with the Disney Express Center. Have you got your bag?
I do.
Passport and everything inside?
Yes.
Good, because we've done that before.
We have.
So when you come in and get up to this floor, you go up one more floor, and then that's the Disney Express. What are you doing?
I was like, this is it, Disneyland.
Watch where you're going.
My day bag is really heavy.
you wrote your film and I was like, fuck day bag, it's really epic.
I think one of the benefits of Standard Premiere is that you're right by the escalators to get off.
Yeah, oh look.
It's literally there. So we have to wait in line so much. That's pretty easy.
That was pretty easy.
The tags are already on, drop them, go. Loved it.
To the park.
To the park. We've got our park tickets, obviously, because they dropped us off on the train. I'm very surprised that they actually gave it to us. Like,
because you thought it was not for package.
I thought unless you had booked the Eurostar through Disneyland Paris's website, you weren't going to get it included. I said to Gary, I was like, oh, I need to go to the toilet. I should probably go now. And I was like, ah, screw it. We'll just go to Disney. And Gary goes, hooray!
Hooray! Someone's excited.
I am very excited. I love Disneyland Paris. This is my... Oh, dare I say it? Could this
I was
be,
about to... I nearly went...
could this be Magic Kingdom? I don't know. There's just something very, like... French about it. Blam.
That would be because it's in France.
It is.
Sauté! Okay, we're just going to have to fill you in. So, Gary just really likes the word salty. I don't really know
why. It means exit.
It does mean exit, but he thinks it's something glamorous, so he says it all the time. And so people in France must walk past him going like, exit! And think, what is this guy on? And I'm like, girl, I know.
I have to deal with this.
So we're actually going into Disneyland Park today. Security is this way at the moment. And then we're gonna hopefully see some things, and then we'll go into the room later.
I think it's time for picture. Ooh, silhouette, yeah. But you will do, because it has to look like you've taken it. Just talking about thumbnails. You know, behind the scenes. You take it because it's your video, but it'll be on my phone because I like to keep the characters. I'm already thinking about what we could do to, but I can't tell you.
Help.
Help me.
Ah, beautiful scenery. But we just missed.
You just missed me thinking I've lost my card to the room and the place.
Before we'd even got in the door.
It's the cruise again.
It's the cruise. But thankfully, there is not that much of a nightmare this time.
No, I'd put it in my actual pocket ready for the door because I was ready to get in because I was so eager.
We're ready to go in now.
Yeah, let's go.
Yay.
Let's not run the whole way.
La-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Hey!
Oh, I love that stabiliser.
Oh, maybe I need one of those in my life. Something to stabilise me.
There isn't enough technology in the world, darling.
Not enough antidepressants in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the award for greatest shot goes to Gary Sim. I won't show you now, but it'll be on the gram one day.
If you want to follow me and Gary, I will put our handles on screen now for you.
Future you might be like, cut that out, can't be bothered.
I mean, there's something I would do, but I'll put the effort in. Will I? If not, link below. Says welcome, Gary. Still going.
The static held it to it. I was like, oh no. Because that happened to me last time. It reset for the next person, and the woman just went, go. In French. Vite, vite.
Oh.
Here you leave today. I'll do it in like a voice. Here you leave today and enter worlds of history, discovery, and ageless. Fantasy.
You're already ageless. You're 40 this year.
Oh, don't tell the world! I'm an ageless fantasy.
Ooh, map.
One.
One to keep, one to use.
Let's make sure I get the English ones this time.
Oh, look at that castle. Isn't that a delight? The weather's really nice at the moment
as
well.
It's really nice.
It's not too cold.
There it is. La belle du monde. I don't know how you say it, but it's la belle.
Le flou de fli.
Like Joey.
Like Joey from Friends.
Sauté. It's not busy, is it?
No. We are at the front of the park and it's first thing.
We literally walked in.
See, this is when... when you first came to Disneyland.
Don't, because I started to feel the twinge at the corners of my eyes. It's because it's the music that gets me.
Crying like a baby. Loved it. Great content. If you want to go and see that series, link below.
I just love this part.
It's your first one as well.
It is.
Something special about it.
Trying to make me cry.
I need that content. I need the views.
I do love it.
Come on, tear ducts.
I can feel it coming. Give me 10 minutes to work up.
Think of all the Mickey things. You can meet Mickey Mouse.
Think of all the pins. Oh, I looked up what pins was in French and I've forgotten what it was, but it was a very difficult word to say. Fascinating facts with Gary C.
So he can ask, where's the pins?
So as we came into the park, we noticed that the Frozen 2 Enchanted Journey show is about to start. Which involves a very mini parade that comes round, mm-hmm. and then a show in the middle. Yeah. So we're gonna watch from here, see
watch
what we can
here,
get.
And then once it's gone past us and they start over there, we can just peer over and be nosy yep. and see what the chat is.
Because what's the name of the whole celebration? Frozen Celebration?
Frozen Celebration.
Ooh! Celebration la Reine de blah blah blah.
Sorry, French people, French speakers, I'm sorry.
Here it is, here she comes!
En route pour Atoualab. Est-ce que l'un d'entre vous connaît le chemin d'Atoualab?
Grandpa said we need to go as far north as we can. And here we are.
Anna!
Je t'entends et j'arrive. Wow! C'est
you ain't the babe! It's Crystal!
So,
we saw the very brief but fabulous show.
I think they sell it as like, it's a parade, it's a shebang.
What you saw is what you got.
What you saw is what it is. Is it worth coming to Disneyland Paris for that? Maybe not. But it was still cool, we still enjoyed it, the float was nice. And Elsa was very pretty. She looked fabulous.
Loved her outfit.
Loved it.
In Frontierland.
We are in Frontierland. This is my favourite land, I'll have you know.
Is it?
Yes. No fantasy land for Adam. I love the... Yeah.
You love the grit, the wood.
The wilderness.
We love some wood.
It's really not that busy.
It's really not that busy. So we're gonna go on Big Thunder Mountain now because it is a classic.
It's my favourite ride.
Is it?
Yeah. In all the parks, Big Thunder Mountain is my fave.
Do you know what I have to say to that? Into the unknown! Now we're in Disneyland Paris.
The benefit of being a two is sometimes they'll be like, two, and you get to skip those last few people.
And you snatch their hand off, go, yes.
And you walk past like, sorry, VIPs.
Just because we're a two.
The struggle!
Mother's in!
Please mind your knees, Grandma.
They wish they were part of me, they must think I'm French!
Why is the water on?
It's cold!
Why is the water on? Ah!
Choked on my tongue!
I love this ride so much.
Oh, donkey!
Oh, oh god!
I was terrified! I started crying as well!
So serene and peaceful when compared to
picture. Hey, the donkeys were scary, they come from nowhere.
So the fact that I went, oh donkeys, and then you went Oh dear. I think my tummy's bruised from laughing.
Phantom menu.
5 minute wait. Phantom Mickey is meeting over there.
Yeah, not long, so that's good. This is a good time to come.
Yeah. So, well, we came in May last time, and May was much busier than it is right now.
That's a lot busier than Phantom Mickey. We've new though then.
Yeah.
That's very charming and comforting in a serial killer old grandma coming back from the grave to get you kind of way. Love it. When did they ever use that part of the line?
Oh, well, I've waited in that line before.
Yeah.
When I came in summer with my family, yeah.
I must have done a lot of off seasons then.
I had the Beyonce fan.
Oh, did
my
you?
Whole family was using it. My cousin was even like, why did I get one of these? And I was like,
you can
didn't watch my vlogs, girl.
You can for a fee.
Salute.
Something. He says it.
Bienvenue, avancez bien au fond de la pièce. Si vous voulez faire les risques, des petits
millions. You may not believe how beautiful it's lived in this house. Fantôme Manor a connu des jours heureux. Et les temps ont changé. Now, curious souls, come, I have more to show you. Entrez, rapportez, et visitons ensemble ce fameux manoir.
He's actually genuinely quite eerie. But you can't see nothing.
I think that's the idea, Gary.
You can't see nothing in
here. Tour begins here, in this area. Perhaps you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Hélas, les choses ne sont pas toujours ce qu'elles paraissent. Tous les contes n'ont pas de fin heureuse. It appears everyone is doomed at Phantom Manor. Even you. And notice this. This chamber has no windows and no doors, which offers you this chilling challenge to find a way out.
I'm all right.
Par ailleurs, il n'y a ni porte ni fenêtre. Par où sortir?
Sortir!
C'est un moyen de vous échapper. Le fantôme des lieux se fera un plaisir de vous aider.
Thank you.
to my home. To Gary C.
Welcome to 71 Questions with Gary C. Gary, tell us about your home.
My home was decorated in the 18th century. It was made by Gary C. the 6th. Function well in the dark.
I can't even trust you to mount a doom buggy properly.
Oh, it was doom all the way. All right, Gladys.
Gladys.
She used to live down the road from me.
It's a very cheap funeral, no one went.
Warlocks and witches, answer this call. Your presence is wanted at this ghostly ball.
I don't think any of these people have been to Lush. I'm not gonna lie, I was more scared of the donkeys than I am.
Get in the box!
Oh, go. I'm a heart attack. You're alright, girl! It's so dark in there, it's actually day still.
It's coming up to 4 p.m, the parade is at 5, so we're thinking we're going to pop into Fantasyland, do one or two things, and then get a spot near It's a Small World, because that way we see the start of the parade. Once it's gone past, we've then got the park to ourselves.
Yeah, then you can start get moving on, so we can go into, there's called Discovery Land.
Yes.
So we can go into Discovery, maybe do Space Mountain and stuff, do a few more things, and then maybe head to the resort to see what it looks like.
Yeah, because we want to take it chill today. This is mainly to pop in, do a couple of our favourites, and then we'll head back to the room and take it chill tonight. Tomorrow is a full-on day. It's also meant to be raining all day, so we'll see how that goes. But we're planning on starting in the studio tomorrow and then coming here tomorrow night.
Yeah.
And we've got dinner booked. So tune in to where we go next week. Disneyland Paris is probably one of the most beautiful ones.
Yeah, I love it. I think it's just really lovely. It's so spacious and really well put together, and the themes sort of, they blend, like look, it just transitions really nicely into the different sections. Because it's one of the newer parks, that's why.
Mm.
It wasn't just a case of chuck the rides in and let's just pray people come.
The Frozen thing's about to start again. So to avoid any copyright, we're going in. Le Tangerine Dragon?
Dragon?
The Dragon place. Dragon! If you've been here when it's busy, you'll know what a privilege this shot is. There's no one here.
Wake up!
Oh,
God, not that again.
It works!
That's what happens when I don't get pins. That noise. Rah.
Into the unknown.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I've never been in here before. This is cool. It's really elaborate.
Different pictures in here.
What's the idea?
The idea is that I take a picture of you in portrait mode, leaning against there, so you've got all that. So then, like, you get, like...
depth.
Roughage. Stone cladding roughage.
Oh, look!
Start doing guest appearances down my local shops. Hello, everyone.
Goodbye.
I like your shop.
Let's have a little moo moo shiro. Oh, that's cool. Hi.
You remember that Magic Kingdom range? They've got their own version of it.
Like the retro style. It's not as extensive as the one in Florida. I think this is... it's kind of similar. How much is a Mickey plush these days? €30.99. It's quite expensive. Oh, what a surprise.
What are you talking about?
This joke's gonna get real old. Anything new? That's quite nice. Tinkerbell one.
I have the Pride ones already.
All right, no need to show off.
In a set.
It's all right, Gary, just watch me struggle.
It's all right. What do you think of these?
I'm not sure I like that.
I'm not sure about them.
Tell you what, I'm a sucker for a Lay's chips. Like, when we get to the hotel later, I'm stocking up.
What flavour is that? Just normal Walker's ones?
I think that's sour cream and chive. And then that's plain.
I'm a plain Jane, mate. I like it. I like
the... We probably should have brought snacks for the room, actually. But then you need to carry them...
the purple potion ears. You see, you touch, you try, you buy.
Go on then. Don't mind if I do.
I really like It's a Small World.
I love It's a Small World, especially in Paris. It's very, very well detailed.
It's very good.
What?
After this, after the parade, people getting to see what I'm like really like. Like, yeah, after this.
What we're doing after the parade, Gary?
After the parade, we could go over to Discoveryland and see what the line is for Space Mountain. That's a bathe. And maybe look in a shop or two over there as well, just to see what it's like around there.
Yep.
And then maybe go to the room.
Go to the room, take a chill. Maybe go to Maggie D's or Rainforest Cafe. We didn't like that last time.
A lot of money, though.
Treat myself?
Always treat myself.
You're on holiday.
Ne fumez pas à bord et n'utilisez pas le dash. Merci.
Welcome to It's a Small World. Remain seated at all times and please, no smoking. Thank you.
What if I'm smoking
Bienvenidos
hot?
Bienvenidos al mundo pequeño. Quédense sentados durante el viaje y por favor,
it just didn't work. London, England. London, England.
This next scene, world area is in Soho. You just get hit by colour and glitter. Ready? One, two, three. Push yourself!
The sun is setting and now it's starting to get chilly. But it's coming to 5 o'clock. It's about 20 minutes until 5 and we've got a spot for the parade. We came right by the It's a Small World gates, which is where the parade starts.
That's where it comes down.
On the left hand side over there is like the disability area, but we're on the opposite side and like 20 minutes before there was no one here.
Yep.
This is February. Just so you know.
Disclaimer.
Don't be rocking up to summer in like 20 minutes before being like, we're gonna spot Adam told us. No, no, no.
I just found my seasickness thing.
Oh, there's Merida.
Speaking French. Who would have known it?
If you could change your fate, would you?
I'd speak French with the same accent. Can you do that?
Parlez-vous anglais?
Close enough.
Ne sont pas autorisés dans les parcs à thème. Merci de noter également qu'il est interdit de fumer, sauf dans les espaces fumeurs indiqués sur votre plan du parc. Merci de votre compréhension. Ladies and gentlemen, to ensure an enjoyable experience for all, we remind you that the use of camera extension cords, such as
the cameras, full stop, is like bye. So 10 minutes before, this is how busy it is on a quiet day.
Always now, get a patch.
Always get a patch. Oh, they're lining up. You can see them.
Here we come.
You can see Goofy.
Exclusive behind the scenes.
It's funny because he's like going up and down.
It must be automatic, the thing that goes up and down. So he just keeps going up and down.
He's having a great time.
Et maintenant, mesdames et messieurs, les enfants.
Oh, this is it.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Disney stars on parade!
Woo!
Oh wow, all the characters! Oh, this is great. One day I'll meet you, Pinocchio, I will. Great shot.
Wendy's got the whole thing to herself.
Yeah, she's carrying this whole show. Wendy girl, you go.
Wendy and the stars on parade.
That guy was hilarious.
Ooh, it's getting very heated. Oh my goodness.
The music.
Drama, drama, get the drama.
Smoke, bubbles, smoke.
That's the money shot. That's spooky.
Yeah, that is.
That shot, look.
Little goblin friend. Oh, here's your friend.
It's Flynn!
Oh, I guess we're always by herself because Philip's otherwise occupied. Dive into Space Mountain area, but we're like walking at the same time as Kristoff, so we're just like
burn, baby burn. Yes, my prince.
It is amazing how quiet everything seems to get when the parade is on. So if you've seen the parade before, or you watch it from where we are, you can potentially get in line for something without waiting too long. We're gonna try out Hyperspace Mountain, and Autopia is open, which is never open when we're here. Just come here. There.
Pat the wig.
Pat the wig. The time is 5:15. Those fast passes are at 5:35. The current wait time for Hyperspace Mountain is 35 minutes.
So we've
a fast pass is cheaper and faster than a.
How do you do it?
Just touch it. It's RFID thingies.
Oh yeah, it looks like that.
Give me your ticket.
Whilst we're waiting the 15 minutes for that to come up,
Autopia is a 15 minute wait. It's also open because it's never open when we're here.
So we'll do it. Who's going to drive?
You.
I think I should drive.
Where you go?
Strap yourselves in, girls. I can't even be trusted to look after my own passport. How am I going to be trusted to drive a car?
Well,
true, it's strapped down.
This is the only opportunity you're going to get to drive a car because you didn't have a driving license.
No, I've never got a provisional either or anything. I'm trusted.
Pink is the new black, don't you know, Parker?
Hello.
Good, how are you? Right, pedal.
Okay, pedal.
Pedal, down, off we go.
Is it wrong?
Steer! Don't take pictures! Steer!
Selfie?
No selfie! Steer the car! No selfie! Drive! Don't you know the rules?
Just one selfie.
No! I will take the selfie. Hi vlog, cheese! And today's star prize is Adam and Gary in an automobile.
Today on Top Gear, we are reviewing this terrible driver.
It's because I'm looking at the thing.
Well, look at the road.
I'm trying.
There is a reason you shouldn't have a license.
There's so many distractions on the road. Oh, a text message.
Oh, you pretty chitty bang bang, chitty chitty bang bang, we love you. And the way Japan, bang bang, chitty chitty bang bang, us a passage cab canard.
So get off your phone! This is nice, we never get to do this. Last time we did it, for God's sake, Gary, I'm gonna get whiplash.
Where there's a claim, there's blame.
Stop, just stop steering it into the metal bar. Just steer it, like, if you're going around a corner, turn left. No, that's not straight.
Oh my God. Where there's a claim, there's blame, or whatever it is.
Wherever there's blame, there's a claim.
This is quite fun, actually. It's quite long, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really long.
You get your weight. Oh, no, stop. Take it off. Off.
Pushing down hard on the thing. Help, stop it.
I literally have to lift his leg off the pedal for him to stop. How do I stop him? Don't put your foot down.
Note to self, don't do this with a Gary C. Smell the fumes.
I love them fumes.
Now, when we do move, you're going to do it slowly. Not fall down. That's it, half. That's it. Very good. Okay, Gary, very good. Stop. There, we go. Right, okay, speed up. A stop, there we go. Lovely. We're getting there. No, there we go.
There's always the temptation to push it more. Do you find that when you're on the road? Oh, why is it going backwards? It's not me doing that. Oh no, still green. Yellow.
Well, Gary, regardless of what the traffic light says, if there's a car in front of you, you shouldn't accelerate.
If the traffic light says go, why can't?
It's still yellow, let's go! There's a bit, yeah. No cars for Gary.
Maybe it never goes for anyone, that's just the look. Part of the thing.
Right, now you've got to park it.
Oh God.
Until the car behind you has parked. Attention, conducteur d'Utopia.
Da 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 da. I feel like there should be a celebration at the end of this that I'm still alive.
More than like I'm still alive.
What number are we?
We're gonna wait for the ladies to tell us where to go. We're gonna be number five. Right, wait, stop. Woo! Thank you.
Yep, I'm a giant trying to get out of a tin can.
That was fun though.
Not for the big boned girls.
I've got a headache like from laughing too much. Softy!
Anywhere I see one. As the sun sets on another day in Disneyland Park.
Softy! Right. Hyperspace Mountain, and then I think we're going to mosey back to the room so we can give you a room tour.
Yeah, while the sun's still up-ish.
Up-ish, yeah. Is that a word? A fish?
It is now.
A fish.
Add it to the Gary C dictionary of moo-moo-shrooisms.
Moo-moo-shroo. A fish.
And the
That's
rest.
All we got right now.
This is the best version of Space Mountain by far.
You think?
Yeah. It's much better. It's more comfortable. It's smoother. You've got the new harnesses.
A bit more intense.
And you've got the Star Wars theme. You will make the trip to galaxy far,
far away. Galileo. Don't
have the rest of that either. Typical. Ooh, this is good.
Dive!
my door, is it?
Tell you what, since they've refurbished that ride, it is so much smoother.
So good.
The seats are comfortable. The Star Wars music, like you said, really, really good.
Up there.
It's now beginning to get to dusk. I want to be able to like see the resort whilst it's still, you know, night, daytime-ish. So we're going to head to the resort, check in, do a little room tour, and then pop back out for dinner.
Oh, noms.
Noms. I'm leaning towards a table service because we've had a quite active day.
And it's always nice to have a little sit down.
Yeah. And Rainforest Cafe.
Maybe.
It's the only Rainforest Cafe I've actually been to and liked.
Okay then.
It's getting chilly, girl.
It's getting chilly, but the magic keeps us going.
Yeah. Well, there's also no clouds as well, so it's going to be a chilly night. And then probably a chilly tomorrow morning.
Nice little cut through here. Go through the arcade.
Well, we like the arcade. And that this is like one of the one things I would like them to add to Walt Disney World.
You can even see on camera how beautiful that is.
Well, I could if it focused. There we go.
I could if it focused.
It smells beautiful in here.
Yeah, it smells like sweets. Sweets. Give me the sweets.
Wondering what we're talking about. We're
talking about legs chafing, thighs rubbing. He just said his thighs are rubbing, and I was like,
oh, I'm chafing.
And I was like, oh, I sprayed deodorant, like, I'm fine. And then as soon as he said it, my mind was like, now you're rubbing.
We give you the full content, girl.
You wanted the truth, you got the truth.
There's a dentist up there, and you can hear people like screaming.
Welcome to Disneyland.
Not screaming, like playfully like, ah! I mean, that's still screaming, isn't it, Adam?
Alright, the lights are starting to come on now.
Beautiful, darling.
See what the castle looks like from a distance.
So just a bit of Gary code for you. If Gary says, let's see what it looks like, it means I'm going to take a picture of what it looks like.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh dear, it is quite nice.
There should be a sound effect.
Feed the birds, tuppence a bag. Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence.
That was the fastest shot in the world because there was someone that walked in. Look at that. Can I live here? This is where the suites are,
yeah. That top one is like the main suite. The Waltz suite, I think, or the Cinderella suite, or Sleeping Beauty suite, one of the two.
One of them lives there.
If you're coming here in the height of summer, they do actually have a fast pass? That's so British. Fast pass. Window here. These are the prices, I'm gonna be honest, very expensive for what it is. Three family attractions is €45. Ultimate fast pass for the whole day is €150.
See the price to pick it up a bit back.
I mean, if you're only here for one day, it kind of makes sense. Oh no, that's high season €150, low season is €120. But I guess in low season you wouldn't really need it. If you watched the last Disneyland Paris vlog series from last year, you'll know that Gary and I popped over to Newport Bay to have a little moo-moo shiroo, and we really liked it from what we saw. Obviously, the rooms, we hadn't seen those, but it's the same price as Sequoia Lodge, and Sequoia Lodge wasn't our favourite, so we'll give it a go. Count how many plugs are in the room.
Yeah, any more than two, and it's a Brucey bonus.
But yeah, we're probably going to pop. We're walking through Disney Village now to go there. It is walking distance, like 5-10 minutes.
Yeah, it's a lovely view as well as you're walking up to it.
Yeah, we're not going to do Planet Hollywood.
It was a sweat pit last time.
We went in last time, we were like, this is way too claustrophobic. No. For us, you might be fine. But Rainforest Cafe was really good. We can actually ask about reservations when we're walking past for Rainforest Cafe, because if they say it's like an hour wait.
Oh, we'll book in now and then we'll be back.
It's really nice. I like the way they've lit this up with like lanterns.
I think Disney Village needs a bit of a facelift to come up to like the caliber of Disney Springs. Because Disney Springs is so good. This looks just quite dated in comparison, in my opinion.
It's quite cool though.
It's retro, I suppose. Oh my god, Gary. The Old Faithful.
Oh, the Old Faithful. How we have betrayed thee.
We're planning on coming here for lunch tomorrow. We love an Erla sandwich. The only problem with the one in Paris is they don't have the holiday turkey.
The turkey one. That's the one that drew me in originally.
Oh, I love that. Yeah, so we popped into Rainforest Cafe and asked if they take reservation. They just said no, it's a like a walk-up thing. They just said it gets busy when the park closes. So I think we're just going to pop back in about an hour.
So when the fireworks have done, so you've got like 15, like till 7:15.
And then everyone starts coming out. So we'll see what's basically available when we come out. I wouldn't mind doing Cafe Mickey, you know.
Isn't that a character thing?
Yeah, but I think it's quite expensive.
Is it? Well, let's see how much.
And we've got our special dinner tomorrow.
Yeah, we have. We'll just see how much it is then.
Yeah, I shouldn't have said anything because now he's going, characters! It's nice because Newport Bay gets its own, like, security thing.
Yeah, it's got its own patch.
That's the old New York, New York that's being turned into a Marvel. Sequoia Lodge.
Sequoia!
And then if you go down that way, I think it's Hotel Santa Fe and Hotel Cheyenne.
Yeah, Cheyenne's a little bus ride away. This looks like a deluxe in America. Look how beautiful it is.
I mean, this is a deluxe in Paris.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's not a cheap one then.
Well, I know it's about the same price as Sequoia Lodge when we last stayed here. I didn't actually check the price of Sequoia Lodge for this trip, but they're similar. The really, really expensive one is a Disneyland Hotel. And also, they're probably going to be the Marvel one when it opens. Oh, I'm already sold.
Lovely.
Luscious.
Luscious.
I like the little lights around.
Yeah.
Oh.
And this time we belong here. We weren't just nosing.
Oh, this is perfect. Check-in was the easiest thing. We just needed our photo ID and our magic keys, and they put the room key on there. We've got a little map to get to our room. We're on the third floor on the east wing, so we're going to go and have a little nosy. But we're also stopping by concierge.
Well, there is the shop there.
Because we just want to ask about dinner. Like, we're not really sure where to go. We're being very indecisive right now, so part of me is like, we're here.
Stay here.
Yeah. But are we just being lazy? Should we make the effort go? We'll see what time it is when we finish the room tour. At concierge, they actually have menus of like the restaurants from around Disney Park. So they had a menu for Cafe Mickey, which we had a look at. And it wasn't really anything we liked.
There's a lot of fishy stuff, like fishy on the Cafe Mickey and fishy on that. Well, yeah. You'd expect, because it's called the Yacht Club.
Yeah. But then there was also like mushroom things, and I was like, bleh. And there's like steak and everything, but I was like,
but steak with fish, which is
or
weird.
Steak with mushrooms.
Yeah.
So it was handy to look at the menus, but like Cafe Mickey, for example, the only thing I wanted on that menu was pizza, and I'm not going to pay 65 euros, which is how much it was, for pizza.
Yeah, because we might do a character thing another day, so it's not worth doing, because it's often the same sort of people.
Yeah. So we didn't like Yacht Club for sure.
And that's well fishy.
Yeah. So we'll probably go to like Rainforest Cafe or Earl of Sandwich
or one of them.
Something easy. Ooh, this is quite nice.
You like the
cashier number 3, please.
Nautical compasses, everywhere.
Mmm.
Very nice.
Have you got your room key to be able to get in?
Oh, I do.
Well done. We're going to 3287. Ooh.
Ooh, that's cool.
Very nice.
Oh, it's nice up here.
3287 this way. It is very Disney Cruise, isn't it? 3287.
Oh, wow.
Hold the key and you'll see.
Take a picture of the number so you don't get
lost. For goodness sake, come on.
Oh, God, that gave me an electric shock.
Great content.
Ooh.
We have a light. Ooh. Room?
Hello.
No way.
This is cool.
Where's the light?
Hang on. Oh, wrong one.
Darkness.
Oh, that's nice.
That's really nice. I wish the cruise ship beds were like that.
When we were checking in, they did say that the bags were in the room, but we've got here and they're not. But we basically called reception and they said, oh, we'll put you through to bag services, went through to them, and then they said, oh, if you didn't give your tickets in, then don't worry, I can take care of it from here. What's your family name? How many blue tags have you got? And then don't worry, they'll be up in 5-10 minutes with the bellman, so that's really nice. She also told me that on disembarkation day, we're not on a cruise.
It feels like we're on a cruise.
It does. On a checkout day, she basically said if you call them in the morning, they can come and collect the bags for you. I don't think it's necessary. We haven't got really heavy bags, but
no.
Yeah, so she just said do that before 11 and that's fine. We can come and collect them for you. But
there's Captain Mickey.
It's nice.
This is maybe my favourite bed out of all the ones, including the Royal Room in Port Orleans. I love this.
Come on.
Yeah, but this has got Mickey ears on it.
That one's got fireworks on it that are Mickey ear shaped.
This is like a...
You're wrong. You're just wrong.
Here is a little dresser, makeup, zhuzh. Oh, look at the things. They're like luggage.
I think they're fake.
They're fake. They don't open.
But already we've got two plugs. Also a British plug.
Wow. Stepping up your game. Goodbye, Sequoia. So, let's have a look at the little table. We've got... Oh, there's leaflets to keep in here. I mean, nice leaflets. And you've got these cushions. Every bed has two lights. Around the room, the dado, not dado rail, what do you call it? The skirting.
I would call that a skirting board, but the skirting's bottom, so topping board?
So around the top is all the different characters in their sailory wares, which is funny because we've actually seen them in their sailory wares in the last series. But I really like this headboard. I think it's great. It is really nice. This is nice. It's a nice little touch with the navy blue. It just pops on the white. It makes it look very clean in here as well. And you've got this chest of drawers, lots of storage space, and it's...
Oh my gosh!
Like, tons of storage.
They're really deep.
Really deep. And this is, again, like luggage. Like, you've got the finish on the corners. Come with me now as I take you into the shower room, also known as bathroom. This has got the, again, nautical sea bearing stuff. You've got your safe, hangers, iron.
See, this is very Sequoia Lodge. This isn't any different.
No, this is very, this is standard Disney. They all have that. But this mirror is lovely.
What's in here? Oh.
It's not rags.
Use tissues.
It's not rags.
Fine. Whatever. Some soap.
Feel the towels.
Towel toucher.
Crispy. Rough.
Not bad, but not great.
It could slip into a packet of Walkers, it's so crispy. But then we've got this nice tiling.
The bathroom is finished well.
It's quite basic though.
It's missing, I think it's missing details in here.
Now this is very...
Ooh, look.
Ooh, little things.
Disney toiletries. So they haven't obviously got rid of the single-use plastic here. It looks like they're starting to, but they haven't got around to it.
This looks like a toilet in a... Like, near a ride or something. One of them toilets, doesn't it? It doesn't look like a hotel themed...
Near a ride?
Well, yeah, like, just in the park. It just looks like a normal stall.
I suppose, yeah.
It doesn't look like it's themed. Like, this room compared to that room...
Yeah.
Is two different rooms.
It is a bit disconnected. Ooh, bell services. After much discussion, we've decided...
After many menus.
We're going to try Rainforest Cafe, like, to get in. Hopefully it should be fine. The cast member at the front seemed... quite sure that we'd be able to get in as long as we came before the end of the fireworks. So it's about 10 to 7 now, so we're gonna quick step over there, get some noms. It's funny how quickly the sun sets when it's...
It's funny how quickly the rats is out of the ship. Look, there's no one about.
I mean, either everyone's at their resort or they're watching the fireworks, I suppose.
I wonder if you can see the fireworks from here.
Well, they're short range fireworks, so I doubt it.
Worst comes to worst, and we can't get Rainforest Cafe, there's McDonald's there. And we know Gary loves a Mackie D's.
I do love a Mackie D's.
In studios they're doing like a Star Wars show, because it's like a Star Wars celebration at the moment. And we can just see it as we're walking past.
What we can also see... Hello!
Stop it! We could always get some chicken nuggets after Rainforest Cafe.
A me!
Or a McFlurry.
I've got my pills. I like case pills, I could have that.
I'm game.
Or we could have the strawberries.
Oh, the chocolate covered strawberries.
Ooh, that would be nice.
I think this was our favourite meal last time, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was really nice actually.
Good food, nice service. Hopefully it's the same today, touch wood.
On this one?
Yeah, that's fine, thank you. So here's a look at the menu for you. We had a chicken burger last time and it was really good. Gary, tell us what you've ordered.
I've ordered the chicken Louisiana and my name today is Serpent, which is basically team slivering all the way.
Yeah, I think when they don't know the name, they just put an animal on there. And we've got some mozzarella sticks to share. I was debating about getting the fajitas, but then Gary was like, no, because you're going to be jealous of my burger and you're going to want the fries. And I was like, I will.
I will.
But the guy's really nice.
Yeah, really great.
And that's what we liked about last time, was it was the place we found nice service and good food.
Yeah, really nice food.
And it's not, like, compared to other restaurants, it's not as expensive. Like, this is 20 euros. Thank you very much. When you raised your eyebrows, it went up. I'm glad we only got one to share. We almost ordered two of those. Mozzarella sticks. Let's see what the... What's this? Is that fried onion? Oh, they're good.
What is it? Fried potato, isn't it?
Fried onion. I just told you.
Fried onion. Oh my god.
This is like you rediscovering life, isn't it?
Yeah, because I've just taken a lactase tablet so I can have cheese. So I've never had these before.
This is the Louisiana chicken burger. It's what I got last time. Gary's gone for the same.
Little chip fryer.
Thoughts, opinions.
Amazing. Francis the server, amazing.
Really, really, really good. So friendly, really talkative.
Adam's talked him into doing the CRP thing in Epcot.
I was like, yeah, go, it's great. So it's about like 33 euros each.
Tickets in there.
So distracted.
Trying to do a vlog and he's too busy looking at the
characters. I think it was about 30 odd euros.
Yeah, so I think it was pretty good for what we
but
got.
But the tip is to get in there before park, like, tip out, because it was busy then.
Yeah, as soon as, because they changed it from being just like a, yeah, come in, sit down, to like a line up outside in the cold, then get a ticket, then come in, then like ugh.
The ticket being this.
Are you supposed to have that?
I don't know. I just took it off the table as a souvenir.
All right, well, I guess you got a souvenir.
Am I not supposed to keep it?
This is like when we went on the Skyler at Disney World. You were like, oh, they had some free hand sanitizer there. I was like, that was a cast member's sanitizer you used.
Well, don't leave stuff out.
Because Klepto here will take it.
The Klepto.
Oh dear. But no, it was nice meal. Really, really, like, he was fantastic. Like, one of the best servers I've had. Do you wanna?
Yeah, let's while we're
let's
here.
Let's get McFlurry, go on. Change of plan. McDonald's is very busy because the parks have only recently closed. Home time.
Back to the patch.
Back to. What's the thing in from Hunchback of Notre Dame?
Sanctuary!
Sanctuary!
Oh, that looks nice, isn't
it? It does look nice. That's the yacht club one. It looks very fancy.
Too much fish though.
Fresh fish!
I love that in the Little Mermaid.
It's one of my favourite things in Disney. Fresh fish!
at the beginning of a scene as well. It just like screams it in your face.
Bay Boutique.
Look at that.
Oh, homeware.
Oh, look, he sold.
Oh, that's nice. I mean, the bowl's a bit small. You can't get nothing in that.
No, come back. How much is that?
€10.99.
Is that a lot?
See the price? I put it back. That's ten. That's £11 for a bowl.
It's a bowl with Mickey Mouse on.
Regardless, it is a bowl.
He's very happy to be here.
I mean, those glasses are a nice size. How much are you? See, that's £4.99. Consistency, Disney. Come on. Oh, that looks nice. Oh, there is a freezer. Oh, it's got hangers in it. So that's not. Oh, Gary. Turn around every now and then. I get a little bit tired of listening to the sound of my turn around. It's got a dangly thing.
No, it doesn't matter because this is the Newport.
It's
this
got is the... a dangly thing.
I'll drink myself regardless. How much?
Expensive, I'm guessing.
€89.99.
It's about the same price as the Disney World ones.
That one on the.
How much is that Big Mickey?
Let's take a guess. Let's play at home.
All right. Well, Mickey Minnie probably going to be the same price.
I say €39.99.
Try €80.
You can sit there, Minnie.
Bah, Felicia.
That's why she's got her head down. She's ashamed.
I'm expensive. These are cool. I mean, that's €219. Tell you where we need to go. We need to go into the art shop in Disney Village.
Yeah, that's nice.
I love that. You didn't do it quick enough. Hang on, hang on.
Oh, God. Life is a struggle.
For you, it is. Oh, home sweet home.
So, this is my pinhole. I got the wardrobe from Beauty and the Beast, which was a highlight from the cruise ship. I know it's Disneyland Paris, but also I like the fact that it says in French, Beauty and the Beast, La Belle et la Bête. Fabulous. I like this Pride little castle. That means I have all of the different Pride pins now, because you know, got to catch them all. And then this, I know it's got a dangly bit, but it's the Newport Bay, and it has Donald on it, so I have
win-win.
Quite a few of the keys, the hotel ones now. And then Adam got these.
Because I need a new notebook and it's super cute.
Very cute. So that's all, folks.
Literally, that's all, folks. We are going back to Disneyland Paris tomorrow for a full day. Thank you so much for watching what has probably turned out to be a very long travel day and Disneyland Paris vlog. So thank you for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe. We've got new Disneyland Paris vlogs on the way. New Disney vlogs coming later this year, which I hope you're really going to enjoy. Like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to all the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time.